Hey everybody, welcome to another battle down here at Curious 2 with Geektech Industries. I've got a friend of the channel, Matt, here with us today. He's got a really interesting list, rebel list to show against us. Why don't you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah, it's basically I just wanted to fly my E-Wing more, and I just finished, I'm partway through repainting it, and more of the green with classic corn horn gets, and all the novels and everything. And I happen to want to fly some B-Wings, so I just sort of threw a list together, and ended up being all right. So I've got a fully loaded corn horn, your stock corn build with push the limit, fire control system, R2-D2 for the shield regeneration after he double taps while he's putting stress and push the limit. And an engine upgrade, because boosting on the E-Wing is a really big deal for if you haven't tried it, try it. You won't regret it. And then the blue squadrons, I figured I'd try something a little bit different. They got advanced sensors, because being able to barrel roll and then do the 2K is a really useful ability, or just taking a focus, because they've got a lot of red in their hit speed dials, like the 2-hard, the 1-hard, these sort of things. And then I wanted to try out the tractor beam, just because it had just come out when I built this list. And it's working out really, really well. You've ever seen an interceptor get hit by two tractor beams and be sitting at range one of a double tapping Corrin.
It's a terrifying, terrifying prospect.
Yeah, it's a defense one interceptor with four dice coming from Corrin with a minimum of a target lock, usually a focus as well. So it's actually ended up being really good, and I've really enjoyed it so far, so I figured I'd give it a fly.
And I brought with me one of my favorite scum lists. I brought Boba Fett on Slave One with Outlaw Tech, Stay on Target, and inertial dampeners, and he's been pretty solid. I got your standard Andru, hangs out at the far edge of the fight list, so Andru with guidance chips, Deadeye, cluster missiles, and glitter stim. So potentially he gets 8 dice damage on that, which is brutalizing.
And being able to choice modify one of them, and then having the glitter stim automatically turn any eyeballs over on both rolls.
Can be really brutal if you can get it pulled off, so I'm hoping to pull it off. And then to round out the list, I got Palib and the Hawk there with Predator, Outlaw Tech, and Twin Laser Turret. And I really like the interplay between Predator and Twin Laser Turret. And I find that just simply flying Palib in a list changes the way people use their ships. They tend to avoid acquiring tokens because I'm going to steal them. So we'll see if that makes any difference to his list at this point. And with that said, we'll see you on the map.
As you can see, we've determined initiative. I'm at 99. Matthew is at 100, so I've taken initiative. We've placed our debris.
Not each other.
We've placed our ships.
Obstacles.
You can see we've also dialed in. We are pretty much ready to go at this point. I'm going to hit go on the timer.
Fantastic.
I used to drive Ken mad.
And game on.
I'm good game, sir.
Good game, sir.
I played the tie.
Okay.
Exclusive.
Oh, looks like
you're I guess you got some twos, Army. All right, well, first blue squadron's doing a 3 straight. And he can take a wild guess what his friend is doing in a minigame.
I'm thinking that it's going to be a K-turn.
Oh, crazy talk.
He wants to fly off the board.
I have actually seen a very good pilot do exactly that, actually, with a whole whack of them. He would just 2K, 2K, 2K in place, just 2K, 1 straight, 2K, 1 straight, just to edge up and down the board, going sideways to wait for them to come to him. It was really cool.
That's actually kind of neat, yeah.
Yeah, especially because it was with, what was the other ship he was running? It might have been an E-Wing, actually. Or it might have been... I forget what the other ship was, but it was a really fast, like, nimble dogfighter that was going up the edge of the board and just waiting for that hammer to come back around.
Yeah.
But it might have been a Falcon Chewbacca. That sounds right. Yeah.
Sounds cool.
Yeah. Anyway, he's just going to take a focus token because he's got nothing better to do with his life. And there you go, where we're barrel rolling. Other one. Similar story.
So, forward 3, focus.
So, in a cluster missile, one of those shots you can do it on. Okay. Yeah, you can't do it on both shots. Oh. At least you can go well sometimes
good old
Palib. Flying air cracking,
he's gonna do a bank one
three blanks
go dashing daring.
I know, right? He's just so fast.
Oh yeah, that Hawk
so fast. Dad Hawk, yo,
that's literally
Dad
like
Hawk.
Put the throttle all the way forward. Get a one bank out of it and then, you know, ease it back.
He's surprising. He's got some nitrous in this sucker. So alright, he'll take his focus.
Things start sort of shuddering as he eases back a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. And Drew is gonna do a forward 4.
Yes.
Good.
Good. No, it's forward 4 on Andrew, getting him up there. Mm-hmm. And he'll take a focus as well.
They go on the punishers. I get to.
And then Fett is going to do a forward 4 as well.
Desperine can actually spit a bomb out front arc.
Yeah.
And then anytime I drop a bomb, I can actually do a free barrel action. And then move.
All right.
Yeah, I tractor beam tokens.
And Fett will take a...
I have another proton
at this point.
And I have two seismic charges.
I'm going to attempt a target lock. Not quite.
So yeah, we both need to do fours, I think, for that to happen.
Yeah, I think so. Okay, that's my guys.
Cool. All right, we got Corrin.
Corrin.
I guess it doesn't. It is obviously isn't relevant right now as we're out of range, but for tractor beam tokens on a large ship, do you still have to generate two tokens to do one barrel roll?
Large ships don't get barrel roll, don't get boosted.
Two on death
cool.
They only get the one.
And then
that's what I was curious about. Man, you mean I can't just put them like on top of all these asteroids every single turn?
I know, right? I know.
What's this game design? Fat
balance and shit? Oh, man.
Nah, what's the point of it, right? Where's the fun in that? Corrin's swing a four straight.
Take a hit back.
I wasn't quite sure how hard Nadir was going to hit the gas.
That's why like swarm tactics.
And then we're thinking probably going to just go ahead and take a boost. One bank. Because we happen to like this angle of approach a little bit more.
Well, that was it. It's like, I'm like, okay, you need to
see what you're doing here.
I'm gonna drop this bomb.
Yeah.
And
I wish I had done the five actually.
Yeah,
I liked
the
five would have put me this
yeah.
here.
Just over a bit, yeah.
And haven't gotten to fly this list. This is the second time I've flown this list.
You still got plenty of room to get through here.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. But
you're gonna set up nicely for next turn, I think.
Yeah. Here's the question.
All right, so I guess we sweep tokens.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, because his action would have been whatever.
Well, you could push the limit if he really felt like it.
You want to get a barrel roll in there?
I was actually thinking about it just to line up.
But
the problem is that there's not a whole lot of green on an aiming dial. There's a lot of white. There's a ton of white.
And I've got five dice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Barrel roll can technically push you forward a little bit, but then
not so much the forward I'm looking for. It's the side motion.
No, you might want to save that push limit.
I think it'll do fine where we're at.
It's good to be home with my dad.
Yeah, that'll be good. Cool. Sweep tokens, nothing's in range. Or at least we're almost positive nothing's in range.
I'm pretty sure.
Yep, barely, but nothing. Cool. Alright, so we got some folks stones falling off over here.
Okay. Alright, there we go. Set some more maneuvers.
Didn't know it.
Yeah, that was the thing. I was going to hit you so hard and so fast.
Hawk 2 bank is white, right?
Hmm?
Yeah, I guess it is. Mm-hmm. I should know it.
Yeah, TLTs aren't quite what they used to be. I mean, I don't have, like, technically, you could have auto thrusters on death round because he has bruised. But, no, give him the guidance.
Nope, it's going to be that.
Yeah, I was like, ooh, like, I only have six hull and I have no shields. Like, and then your marksmanship and stuff, I'm like, yeah, I think I'm in a bad way here. Let's see what happens. And then, yeah, I took one damage.
Yeah, just my dice. Yeah. Horrible. Horrible dice.
Let's see, 26. 30. 33. Yeah, he's like 40 points. Then you're focusing on him, while you're focusing on Death Ray, Power Runner, and the Tie Fighters just blink away. And you're like, yes, we killed Death Ray. Why are our ships falling apart?
What's that strange burning smell?
Yeah.
He's dead, he's dead. What's that burning?
Know,
what's that thinking noise I hear from the glass?
Yeah. The Tie Fighters, but it was like, if one of the Wyverns put at least one damage, there's no point.
Decisions.
I know, right?
This is actually a very critical turn because there's a few things that can happen
so
here.
In situation, like,
it partially depends on what you do.
Alright,
because that nut's got a TLT.
You ended up, I could have dropped
yeah, he's got a TLT.
And
on
he does!
Yeah.
I have another version of this list that swaps out the TLT for an ion cannon turret instead.
Ooh, like that. Helps Boba a lot.
Well, that's my thought as well, and it also helps push Palov into range to use his ability.
Just ships with lots of shields.
Yeah, totally.
Like,
yep.
Six shields, and like, if you only rolling one defense dice.
Okay, we're
cool.
Dialed up.
Yep.
Like,
I think we are.
Okay, bring it on.
Cool. Let's start with the inside guy. He's doing a one bank in this
one
way.
Shot.
Exactly
nice.
What I thought.
Oh,
like,
yes. Wasn't
so like
too much else they were going to be doing these two. Let's face it, these guys are basically just giant hammers looking for an anvil. That's what a B-Wing is. There's nothing subtle about a B-Wing.
No,
not
in the slightest.
Also, I'm actually thinking we're going to take a target lock.
Oh,
onto Master Fett.
Ooh, okay. Just see what you're doing there.
Similar story over here, except he's doing a two-bank, because a friend of mine once watched me crash the whole TIE Swarm through its opening paces, and then you learn how to formation fly. So, for anyone who doesn't know,
so
if you're banking in formation, if you want them to stay more or less level, you need the inside one to do one slower than the outside turn. So if you're
so
trying
like
to get
one,
two,
two
threes,
three,
one, two, three,
if
you've got a whole group of
three.
Like and don't try and do four wide because you will end up running into your own guys. And you'll lose actions and it'll be terrible. I feel really bad about it. Take it from experience. Don't go through yourself.
At that point, A is Ed, eh? All right. Palib is going to do a red bank three.
Oh, interesting.
That will be a collision.
I guess. Me at the
but really,
back.
No matter what he was going to do, it was going to be a collision.
All right. Yeah. I'm wonder if the one bank wouldn't have just neatly slid you right here. But.
No.
No,
I don't think so. In any case, he gets
anyway,
a stress.
A stress and a focus for his trouble.
And a focus token. Which was going to be his action anyway. And Drew is going to do a bank three.
Bring
himself around a bit. Start setting up for his attack run.
You know it.
He'll take a focus. And then good old Fett is going to do a forward four, except he's going to stay on target that into a K-turn four instead.
Interesting. He's got the K-turn four on his dial?
Yep.
I don't actually think
sweet.
I did.
Oh, right,
so
the other one, yeah.
K-turn
the
four.
One, K-turn, yeah. For some reason, I thought it was a three. That would be far too good.
I know, right?
I don't think you've actually got anyone in right now.
Damn, that's a little further than I wanted to be. Or not as far as I wanted to be.
Yeah.
So I take a stress and a focus. But at least I get a bunch of rerolls.
Yes, you do.
Okay. Fat has no shot.
Nope. I still got a corn to move first.
Oh, that's right.
Also, yeah, no, just now that everything's moved, I was considering moving corn and doing a three bank out this way and then boosting back in away from Nidiru.
Yeah.
Which I thought might have been clever, but we went for the one bank instead.
Went
and
for
figured,
the one bank, trying
you know
to get
what?
That shot.
Nidiru's going to be doing all of this at some point anyway. There's only so long you can avoid that shark. So.
Truth told.
At some point, you just sort of got to knuckle down and just accept the fact that this is happening.
So it's like
and do it with the best you can with it.
Yep.
So, with that in mind, I believe we're out of range 2, so you're not going to be stealing tokens. So we're going to be pushing, dealing with Korn to take a focus for his initial action.
Mm-hmm.
Push the limits, and he's going to just take an evade token on this one.
Okay, so he focus bait.
Focus
bait,
yep.
Okay.
And then I think we're firing lasers.
Top of the stack, you bet.
Yep.
So Fett has no shot.
So
his arcs are bad. That was bad for me.
Yeah. Korn. We got ourselves
range
that I believe is 2. Yeah.
Custom
missiles
is really
so
especially in the marksmanship.
Let me get those out of the way here. Two dice versus your three dice.
Should be so desired.
And I still will actually.
I'm actually just gonna take the two hits.
Save that focus for your defense. Okay.
100%.
Now is that range 2?
I believe it is range 2 is what we ascertained. So
oh,
it's range 3.
It is range 3.
Oh, very good. So you get 3.
Oh, damn, I'll take it.
All right. So we got 2 hits coming in.
And now I get 2 blanks and a focus. Now. I'm going to reroll two of those because I think two of them are in range
I want to double
one.
Check that the second B-Wing
yeah,
back
check the other
is actually at range one.
One.
Just without bumping anything here.
I can only turn them into hits.
Yep, we are at range one pretty much right there. So, yep, you get 2 rerolls.
So I'll reroll these two.
Yeah.
And turn that up into a focus.
With your focus
from the
yep. Cool, so you take nothing because you only
nothing!
Have two. Perfect. Now, what will happen there is Korn will get a target lock from his fire control system.
Okay.
Who cares?
Boom shakalaka. Or something like that, anyway.
Yeah.
Cool. So.
That was 8-7. Drew.
Well, I don't know if you I don't know if you heard the rumors that are going.
Uh oh. That's range 3.
There's a Frybird going on.
There's definitely a Fry Thief run. I think it's
Fry Shark.
Fry Shark. Yeah, so 2 dice.
Some
Drew.
I want to throw some greens my way.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. This won't be a thing.
It's going to be a thing.
Oh, you didn't actually end up target locking, did you?
No.
Oh, so there aren't missiles coming my way. What is this crazy?
I have to get within range, too, anyway.
Oh, true.
It's cluster. True. So 2 dice for my primary, which is 2 hits.
I'll do. I'll do nicely.
I'll do, pig.
I'll do.
Okay.
I'll do.
Two evades anyway, so more than enough.
Oh, yeah. And we got the evades over when we needed it. But we've got TLTs probably shot something else.
Coming up here. Oh, just barely?
Oh, yeah, you got him. I would agree.
Range 3 and just barely. Just all three of them I can
all
do.
Just arrange three, yeah.
I am going to feed them into Corrin, though.
Corrin? Yeah, just look for those guys.
So first volley with Predator.
And
you only get three because it's a secondary. So,
yep, but we do have an asteroid in the way of that one, for sure.
Yes, it is obstructed in this case.
Oh, what's going on with this laser? It's way more bright than that, I promise. Come on.
A lot of people asking about it.
That's good.
Okay. Cool, hopefully.
Yeah, we're definitely
yeah, just over that. Cool. Okay, so three dice from the secondary turret, first volley. I will Predator those two.
Predator one.
Or one of them, that's right.
Yeah.
And I'll turn it up with my focuses.
Focus token? Cool, so three results.
So three hits.
Got four evade dice. Coming strong. Four
two evades,
and then we might as well spend the evade token because... I can take one now, I can take one later.
Yep, and then I will take my second volley.
Headshot.
I'll Predator the blank.
For
and
one total.
One hit. Womp womp.
Now, let's watch my dice roll all blank on. Close, but not cigar.
Two evades.
Two evades. We're good.
All right.
Okay. B-wings.
B-wings.
Now we have decisions to make, because I see that hawk there, and it looks really tasty.
Mm-hmm.
I could upgrade.
I think you need to start chipping away at Master fast.
Okay.
So, two range one shots. So I just want to take eight dice. Or do I want to try and drop your defense by one?
You could use the first one to drop my defense by one and then primary four dice.
Hey, that's what I'm thinking.
One.
That's the option here.
It's probably worth it.
Yeah, we're definitely thinking about it. Because we got the target lock as well. Sure, we'll try. Why not? So we'll go with the tractor beam from far one, because why not?
Yep,
so we got three. We are going to target lock that for sure, though.
Yep.
So we got two of these.
So isn't there two shooting?
Yeah, 21, yeah.
For one hit still.
Disaster.
All right.
Well, I think your odds are fairly good on dodging this one.
I'll re-roll that one because of, because of Fett's ability. I'll re-roll that one because of Fett's ability. One evade! All I needed.
Disaster. Well, I'm probably just going to take a four dice primary on this next one here, because why not? There we go. I ended up rolling an extra one in there as well. Perfect. All right, well, we're going to just use the target lock on these two, because I figured...
Okay.
I didn't think we were going to get to range one of those. I've taken that focus. Because, yeah, otherwise it would have been good.
Yep.
As it is, we got a hit and a crit on you, so that's something.
We might get some shields off. So, first, and I'll reroll that one because of Fett's ability. Two evades.
So, nothing.
Good job, Fett. Keep it up, buddy. Okay, so now we dial it in.
Yeah, we're not going to be double tapping this turn, I don't think so.
No, you're not going to take the double tap?
Nah. If I'd managed to sink a little more damage into you, it might have been worth it to then just hit and run. But considering I took no damage, nah, I'll just keep the options open.
So I'll sweep my tokens.
Cool. One target lock hanging around at least.
Okay.
Decisions. Probably end up doing last but not least an E-wing.
That's usually pretty easy to figure out for me.
Oh,
okay, Dagger Squad.
Alright, so first blue. Yeah, blue's
Les bleus.
Les bleus.
I'm gonna do a two bank up just in here. Something like that, alright.
Okay.
And you know what? I think for his action, he's actually getting a barrel on.
Alright. Oh, I'm gonna try and block off Fett, huh?
Oh, I think Fett's gonna be inertial dampening no matter what I do here. It's more so that I think wherever the hawk, there's a potential for the hawk to end up somewhere where I couldn't get a shot at it. As it is, if I can make it bump and not get an action. Because you'd have to do basically a one bank or a one straight to clear that stress, unless you just suck it. Which is a potential, but yeah, no, I like there. Alright. Now this guy, I'm just gonna move your die a little bit here.
Yeah, no worries.
Doing
just
a one bank
over to the side.
Just cause.
Alright.
Him just about right there. And thinking
this
only goes so well. This only goes there's only so many things you can do at this point, like this is gonna be a focus token.
Call it day in the office.
Now Corrin is gonna do a one straight. Clearing off his stress.
Behind you.
Mm, it's just going to end up pretty much right about there.
Mm-hmm.
And for his trouble, Corrin's just thinking we're going to take a focus and evade and a stress. We'll push the limits. Full
push the limits of focus evade, okay?
Yeah.
Alright. Oh, wait. Why did Corrin move?
Sorry, I'm bad.
I mean, he's probably not going to do anything different.
That's fine.
That's fine this turn.
I apologize. That was bad of me.
So this guy's going to bank one. Not really in the end, no.
Yeah, no, I figured that wouldn't change
much
what was going on this
turn. So that's going to shed his focus, or shed his thing, and he'll take a focus.
Cool.
And Drew is going to do a bank three.
Yeah.
Nobody ever saw that coming.
No, never. Let me guess. Target lock Glitterstone.
He will focus.
Oh. Yeah. Fascinating. Cool. All right.
Fett's going to reveal a bank one, but he's going to, you're right, he's going to inertial dampener.
Yep.
And so I shed my stress, but then I do a zero, a white zero, and take my stress back. Or give my stress back. There we go.
Cool.
And he's going to stay right there.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't count as a red maneuver, so his outlaw attack doesn't trigger.
Doesn't trigger.
And he gets a stress. Like, that applies a stress before I get
before
a chance to take an
action.
So he's lost out on any potential action.
That's okay. He's got range one, and he's got two people at range one. He's getting lots of juicy rerolls on
that's
the four-dice
right.
shot. So
that's the idea.
Okay, to do.
Okay, ooh, top of the stack. Fett's going to do his range one four dice primary on
numbers, no numbers.
No number.
Cool.
The red guy right there.
Okay, there. Cool. I like it.
So four dice, two rerolls. Or, whoa, sorry. Start of combat. Trigger glitter stem on Andrew.
Oh.
Because it has to be.
That's at the start of
combat.
Yeah, totally. Yep.
So start of combat, trigger glitter stem on Andrew.
Cool.
And I think that was it.
Yeah, nice. Cool. Sounds good.
Okay.
Oh, he's got Deadeye.
And I will steal his token, sorry.
Sure. Yeah, okay.
No problem. Oh, there. Okay, so now Fett gets his three hits.
Cool. And you reroll,
oh, and reroll
those,
that
yep. one.
Probably
long here.
I can only reroll it once, so
yeah.
Three hits.
Cool. All right, so we got one whole mighty defense dice. Womp womp. So, three shields off of no numbers.
No number.
Actually, I think I managed to very cleverly put my number token away.
Which number is it?
But it's a 21.
I think I have a 21, actually.
I can pull mine out. I'm just going to pull the three shields off, and then I'll just go hunting real quick here.
Okay.
Got these three shields coming off of the left one.
It all lines up anyway.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so that was Fett. Now your Corrin gets to shoot.
Corrin does. Yes, he does indeed. So Corrin is probably just going to end up shooting, just for the sake of curiosity, if we've got Archon.
We do have Archon Paladin. Range 2.
Yeah, we'll just shoot the hawk. I think the hawk needs to die pretty quickly here.
All right.
So you got three dice, range two. I'm pretty sure that'll be only going to be anything else. So let's get that 1 of 8 out of there.
All right. Wow. Wow. You got nothing because you're focused on Fett.
No. Yeah. Well, I can spend the focus token for one hit, and I don't think I am.
You're going to save that for defense? Okay, I'm not going to bother rolling then.
But we are going to move the target lock over from fire control system.
Oh, yes, okay. And then Drew is going to Deadeye his cluster missile.
Yeah, he is. Figured that was going to happen.
Use that.
Being Lone Wolf. Yep. That's pretty good as well.
I like Lone Wolf, but I tend to accidentally bring him in too close. So, no other friendly ships at range 1 to 2, so both of my cluster missile shots are going to be four dice.
This is where we are.
Guidance chips lets me turn up one, and if I get any focuses, that turns up because it delivers two.
Actually, I can give you a token that I use just one of the packs. It just indicates any super.
Oh, the tracking token,
yeah. Yeah, just remember that it's Glitterstone that way.
Alright, so.
Yeah.
First volley from that on Corinth.
Well, you see, ordinarily we'd call that a bad roll, but then you remember that this is Glitterstim.
And then I Glitterstim that up into four.
Four on three. This is where Ewing's like to go up and smoke
on
me.
On the first shot.
So four hits. It's going to be
two
of eights. That's all right. And I'm actually, because it's not going to get a better opportunity, might as well spend the evade token for three of eights. So I'm only taking one shield in this instance.
Yep.
Which is a good start, which means I'd still die if you roll all hits and I roll all hits. This is still a thing that can happen. All
right. And so second volley. Wow.
Speaking of.
So,
and Shalak, so
and guidance chips will turn that up into a hit. So two crits and two hits.
Yep. So, come on, evades.
Yes!
Oh! That's the one we wanted. We'll spend that focus token every single time.
So that's,
take it to the bank.
One
shield. So Corrin's lost two shields from the whole thing.
Damn!
So about the best result I could possibly expect.
Yeah.
That was
lucky
solid on my part.
That was very solid.
I was expecting to lose all my shields.
He still got that to
one
turn.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Not that there's anything shooting in, but. So you.
Yes,
got...
I can TLT the one guy.
Why wing.
Okay, so I will TLT the no number to Y wing there.
Yeah.
So first volley. Oh wow.
That's all.
I will predator one dice.
Yeah, two focus
tokens.
Just
turn it up.
Yeah.
So
I'll
that's
just
the
mine
one. You can use yours.
Just to make it easy. Yeah.
So that first volley is three hits.
So can't
doesn't
avoid
really
it,
matter.
Because
yeah.
A beam angle got the one agility, so
there's
he's
one.
Taking one.
And
then
second volley.
Roll more than one.
And I focus that up.
So more than one, so it's going to be two. Yep. Don't even need to roll it. So it's all of one B-Wing's shields gone, which is actually reasonably hard to do, I find, having played a fair bit of B-Wings in another list that I've taken to some tournaments. All right.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay, now we're down to your
five
blue squadron.
Dice over there, yeah. All right, well, I think I've got two. Got a range one and a range two here, don't I?
Yeah.
I think the back one's going to go first, and the back one is going to just
take
go
the range two?
And ten take the range two, but he's going to take the tractor beam.
Yeah, he is.
That's going to be the best.
To give him a nice there. Ooh!
Got two hits. So
and I only get two evades.
Come on.
Ah!
Yes!
So no damage, but he's only got one evade dice now.
So a tractor beam token, and what I need to figure out is if I can barrel roll you in such a fashion that you are still at range one of him, but possibly slightly closer to Corrin.
No.
Because do I have to barrel roll you or boost you at this point?
You
oh,
must
wait,
barrel
boost
roll
you.
Or boost.
Oh, I can. Oh, but it'll put you, me.
But you can't do it. You can't boot. You, it ha, it still has to be.
It
like,
has to,
oh,
yeah,
can't collide.
You can't collide. It's only the asteroids that it ignores that for.
Exactly.
I'm just thinking. Yeah, no, it's just going to stay where it is. It's just going to be one less defense.
Okay.
Figure that's probably
just keep,
the best
keep
option.
Them there nice and tight.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
So we got four dice on one now from the next one, range one.
Whiffle!
Not so much. Four
that
hits.
Is not a whiffle. That is the opposite of whiffle.
That is a fantastic roll.
Man, I get a single defense dice. Oh, yay! I only get right.
Three
hits. Three
hits. Bring the pain.
All right. So a shield and two.
Leaving on
two. Leaving two hull left on pallet.
Perfect. All right. So at this point, Corrin is going to take his double tap. So we're going to shoot three dice at that defense one hawk.
Ooh.
With a target lock. Target locking the two blanks that we got.
Yep.
Four two hits and a focus.
Oh man, this is gonna be bad.
Right.
This is gonna be really bad.
And
evade, so I take one more hit. I'm still not dead. Gold Palum!
Would have rather enjoyed that, not gonna lie.
Wow, okay. So that's bottom of the stack. Can I sweep any tokens?
Yep, so no more glitch gem.
He sweeps the...
Yeah, that pulls this off, and otherwise I think we're good to go here.
Yep, I think so.
Because the,
nothing else to do, yo.
Yeah, because fire control system keeps the target lock even after Corrin's double tap. But what I will pull out is the fancy... I love that the E-Wing came with the can't shoot token.
Oh,
because
yeah.
It's perfect for Corrin, because Corrin literally he
can't
shoot because he double taps, so it works out really well, and that way is a visual reminder as well. Ladies and gentlemen, more reasons to buy Kate. Preferably from Andrew McGregor.
There. Drew. You did good, buddy. You did good. It's just that he did better.
Hey,
Ross.
Hey, Ross.
Let's go and see it.
Uh-oh.
I know. It's Matthew.
B-wings and a fire spray?
B-wings.
E-wing. He's got, two B-wings and Corrin.
Okay.
And both the B-wings have tracker beams.
And I managed to get four hit rolls from the cluster missile on Corrin. Two shields.
Total.
Wow.
Yeah, because he managed to roll enough. And
just
he had a focus and an evade token, so he managed to use those to evade all of the big hits.
Great effect.
Which is
fine. Oh, Andy's got R2-D2 on.
Yeah, so he's
going to
do a green
shield
next turn and regen.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
That sucks.
At least he thinks he is.
So that was your clusters with Nidru you got
clusters
off?
With Nidru, and I used guidance chips and my my glitter sim.
And you got four hits on each one?
Four hits on each one. Still only managed to do two shields.
Wow.
I know, right?
That's some
good
rolling. Some good evade dice.
On both sides.
Okay, bring it on, B-Wings. All
right, so we're going to be using some advanced sizes
first
things.
All right,
so
you have
to
put a match?
Yep.
Because I don't think I'm going to be making that without it. So we're going to be doing a barrel roll.
Like my day? Oh,
poor James's dice just kind of...
Back over this way.
Kind of crapped out on... What's that?
Just to there.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's going
to
be revealing a 2K.
Yeah.
Do you want me to do that for you?
Please, if you wouldn't mind. I'll just post this token over there for him. And,
beep.
Well, you came up
beep,
with
beep, 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 beep,
beep. Cluster missiles.
There we go.
Mark him with his pet stress token.
On both attacks,
this is
eight.
Why advanced sensors is so good with B-Wing.
Wow.
Anything with a barrel roll and a sensor,
that's
consider that's advanced sensors.
You'll
just be happy. And now
I'll advanced sensors and push the limit on debris.
This ship should be just
yeah, oh yes.
Debris.
Now you see the trick here is he's advanced
when
sensoring. Now the question is if I need to barrel roll him as well, or if
before.
I think
I
he can make
demo
it just on his own. Straight where he is, because I'll give you a slushy and a little secret. He's also doing a 2K.
Mm-hmm.
It's just whether or not
all
I don't think he's actually going to quite make it.
He can
it
barrel roll
that's
over, but then he collide.
I don't think
I don't he you can barrel roll this way because Corrin is too tight this direction.
I think I might.
Oh, you can barrel roll over, but then your K turn will collide.
I think I'll actually end up right
that
in the middle there. But
mm-hmm
let's try it out. I mean, he's got nowhere. He's got nothing better to do.
He's got nothing.
So.
Okay then.
And we're going to as far back along until we're as far back as we can be, which is about right there, without touching Mr. Fett.
Okay.
So that the back of our base slides back so it's not touching pretty much just to there. I guess.
No, that wouldn't
so
work.
So it would have to be. It could be slightly forward though.
Yeah, there
it can still be
there
perfect, yeah.
Because
that was probably back to the base, so it's easy enough to get to there.
Nub.
And then 2K.
2K.
Question of the day.
Can he 2K his way in there? Oh my god,
yes,
I think he can.
I think we're going to be all
right
here.
You're right about
this
there.
One. Yeah,
there
gotta
go
get it as tight as we can.
Look at that.
Like a glove.
Oh no, you're not.
Fine,
you're on
not
your nubbins, and you're
what's
touching
that
my guy.
I am gonna fly
you're
my
kidding.
No,
squad.
No, I'm not.
That's what we call the
Captain Jonas at the helm.
That's what we call in by a curled nut hair.
Yep, pretty
I'm
much. And right about.
I love that
day. Ship. Oh, there you go. Right about there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Solid.
Oh, well.
Oh well.
Had to happen sometime.
Hey, that's what flying these lists is about, right? Figuring out where they're going.
Well, I don't think he was making it any other way he was going. I think that was the best odds we had.
Mm,
so.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's your twos. My five.
That is the twos. That is definitely the twos.
He's going to do a straight four.
Oh, interesting.
Nobody ever expects Palib to get the fuck out of dodge. So he's getting the fuck out of dodge.
It's actually going to cause some problems, potentially.
Exactly. Nobody ever does red moves with the Hawk, so I found that combining him with the LA tech has given him a little more ability to move around that throws people totally off. Okay, and then I guess that's Andrew, who's going to do a two-bank.
Yep.
So you got a boss, Bill?
Yeah. Oh, no.
Ew.
Oh, no.
The question is, are you on the asteroid or going to be on the asteroid next?
And I'm on it.
Yeah, we're on it. Okay.
Interesting.
Roll that dice, my friends.
And I'll be coming off of it next turn, too. So.
Yeah, you will. There's no way around this. There's a whole kettle of worms.
That's lame.
What's
okay,
that?
So here comes the roll.
Oh, well.
Nothing.
Yeah, but,
there you go.
You know, dice are a fickle bit.
Pulled it out.
No, no.
But he gets no shot.
And,
I've got a reasonably hurt
like
B-wing.
My green dice suck.
Fett.
They always suck. They always have, and probably always will.
Cool.
Which I hope he can actually accomplish.
I don't think he's going to.
Okay.
There's any way
try not
because
to
I bumped and couldn't go my full distance.
Agility.
Yep, you're right. Right on your nubbin.
Yeah, it's going to be the same problem.
At least I shed my stress.
What?
You do shed the stress and go bump.
But
bump in the night.
Because all those rerolls, yo. All damn rerolls.
Oh, you know it. So at this point, we've actually got a little bit of a trick with Corin here because I wasn't quite expecting to be there.
Mm-hmm.
So he's doing a one straight.
Oh, no.
He's literally just going to clear
collide,
his stress.
Yeah.
He's going to collide, but it does get him a shield back for the green maneuver.
It does.
So
he'll shove him forward a bit.
He's literally just going to go bump. So. I was expecting to have a shot on the butt of Fett with some tokens. As it is, there might not be so many tokens involved.
Yeah,
but it will be a shot.
So, top of the stack, Fett's going to feed this guy four dice.
Seems, sounds about right. Numbers! What did numbers ever do to you?
Numbers!
Numbers.
I hate numbers. So I'll reroll that one, and I'll reroll that one.
Sounds about right.
That's a boba.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that just kicked that over.
Yeah, it
was
a hit, so.
There you go, four hits.
Sounds about right. Oh.
Yep.
So four shields off of that there, Blue Squadron.
Awesome. I'll
that's
take
how
it.
That about goes.
Well, I'll take
time,
it.
So.
And
cool.
Then you're... Oh, you get no shot with Corin.
Oh, we got a shot with Corin. We got
no.
A shot on Boba.
No, you don't.
30.
He can shoot Boba.
Oh, he does not shoot. I'm crazy.
Because
I'm
he double tapped last time.
I definitely double tapped. No, that
oh,
was...
Oh,
yeah.
Yep, but you do clear that at least, so...
Oh, yes. So I'll move it off at the end of the round so I don't
yeah.
Forget about it.
Now
I do have some B-wing shots, though. I've got
oh,
a B-wing shot specifically.
I still got shots.
Oh, he's still got a shot.
He may not have a shot, but he certainly does.
Yes, he does.
So he's going to take his...
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
He's definitely on the asteroid.
I thought he'd come up just short. So that's... Oh, yeah, range two there.
Or range three on the other one.
Yeah, well, either
not
way,
that
it doesn't
effective
matter.
Yet.
Who has the most...
They're one apart.
So that
this
guy.
This is no numbers. This is numbers.
Right.
So
no numbers is taking my first volley.
Yep. Guess what?
And I'll focus that up. Or actually, a predator that, sir. Oh, well.
Can't.
Two hits.
Can't dodge it. I only got the one.
More than one.
So, one damage card from the deck.
He almost
spent.
I almost did, yeah.
You did.
And then,
dead.
I don't think it was going to matter anyway.
No,
second
fine.
Volley, and a predator that one.
Big takes
care.
There
hit.
You
go.
One left on
there.
Alright. That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
If I got him to turn around, I'd feel a lot better about this, but as it is, I think he's just...
have a shot, because yeah, that's
yeah.
An instructor.
That could be terrible for Fett right now.
But
yeah. Okay, and then...
We got some B-wing shots.
Yeah, you do.
And we're just thinking we're going to take that B-wing shot onto the old payload here.
Oh, really? Oh, you're going to get
ooh,
that last shot
gotta
on
get
him,
Dad. Are you
yeah.
Kidding me? I
that's
can't... CLTs
three.
On B-wings are not good.
Range
three,
isn't it?
Question.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's going to be range three no matter
yeah.
What here. So.
Woohoo! I get three dice!
Three on three.
That's
good.
Oh,
crits.
Good
start.
Crits.
Got to dodge them both.
I do. I still get that focus, though.
Yeah.
Oh!
No! Work. Well, two crits get fed out from the deck, so we can see what's going on.
Yeah. Let's see what do we got here. A
this is where you want to
weapons
see
failure
hits.
And weapons failure.
Oh, wow.
That's all right.
That's interesting.
It's not something you want fed to
then Palad bites it.
That's his turn. Sweet. Good times.
Yeah, Palad's always the first one to die. Okay, I guess that's it. Sweet tokens
yeah.
And sets of maneuvers.
10 to agree, sir. 10 to agree.
That's
so.
That's okay.
I think we got at least one to be right here.
What's up? We look for Dippy. I dropped the pay. Oh, Matt.
Hey.
think I have team yet.
Nice.
Oh, there it is. Right here. Up there.
Oh, yeah. Good eyes. Now I dropped something.
Done this math before. Oh, man, this is... Corn shooting. They're shooting from corn. Basically, promising guarantee that.
Corn actually gets to shoot this turn, yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, he does.
You should leave
the
fries out for the fry monster.
It's not a monster. It's just misunderstood.
Playing that other skill list too much recently. Corn.
Okay. Well.
Corn, my corn.
Those are going to be my three tokens. How many squad points do you have?
100.
100, so am I. Go ahead and roll a dice. If you get a hit or a crit, you get to choose if you get some initiative. Alright, so you've got two pilot skill twos and seven. I'll take initiative.
Just accept that.
Okay, so do you have three other? Do you want to use these?
We're all dialed in?
Oh no, we just figured out.
Oh, you finally figured it out. Okay.
Yeah, it's basically a whole bucket of worms. It's basically got
bucket of worms.
Oh yes.
So 35 minutes left on this match.
Oh, that's plenty of time the way this is going. yes, that's loads of
At
time.
At this point, I may have time for one more against Andrew.
Actually, you know what? Heck, why not? We'll just do that one because I think that's going to end up being a lot in the long run.
Okay, Blue Squadrons, go.
Blue Squadrons, go. So first one is going to be this one. He's just going to go ahead and do a one bank over that way.
Okay,
if you wouldn't.
I got him.
Thank you.
I got him back.
And that lets him do his action.
Yep.
There he is. We're just thinking. We're just gonna barrel him back that way. Now it's gonna basically line him up for our next turn to do that. There's only so many ways this B wing is gonna. It's been pretty much dead in the water, so probably just gonna focus. He seems like he's in an okay spot otherwise.
Right.
Now this other guy is going to make life slightly interesting because he's doing a one bank just to clear the stretch.
Oh, that pretty much just sort of moves him up there.
Basically, yeah. It doesn't even bring the back end around all that much because you've got to line it up with the back of the base. So no action, but
so
the most important part is the clearing of the stress.
I
needed to clear the stress this turn, and there wasn't really many ways on a B-wing to do that.
No, there aren't. Sometimes you just got to bite it and collide with somebody, so
pretty much. Nadru.
Nadru is going to do a bank one.
Oh, interesting. So he's definitely
going to get him off the...
That's right.
Not
hitting that.
No.
Oh, yeah, no. This is happening. This is a happening.
Oops. Hey, you're two.
Oh, he takes a damage.
To start.
And because he came off the asteroid this turn...
No action.
No action.
But
so
he can shoot.
He did collide again, yeah. So,
yeah.
You escaped your action.
But
because
I'm off of it now,
you're free.
I still get to
shoot,
right?
Yeah, absolutely.
You're free to shoot.
Boba Fett.
Yes.
Let me guess.
Boba Fett is
inertial
actually
damper?
Gonna... No, can't. I can only inertial damper once.
Oh!
So I will, however, stay on target that into a bank three instead.
Oh, very good.
Ooh.
Now that'll turn into a red maneuver, which will stress him out, but it will... Oh, man.
Oh, boy.
That was...
That's
I,
very
I
daring.
I just kept to the straight.
There. Okay.
Huh.
I think I can actually turn one next turn.
I don't think Slave One has a turn one. Hard two. Sure got a hard two.
I think a hard two will keep him quiet.
Hard two
would
do it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no, be dashing, be daring.
It has a
more.
Be
swift,
so. He's technically six, so.
Now that
gets
is
a stress,
so it will be out.
Because he has
attacking.
To keep it red, he gets a focus.
Corrin, one straight. She's going to be a shield back.
And as I place
I wasn't sure
board,
if you're just
going
to. For whatever reason, thought you still had inertial dampeners, so I was just going to sit still, and if I tried to bank into you, I'd be
running into
you. I
wish that I could reuse inertial dampeners, right?
That would be amazing. But.
Suddenly they would cost four.
Oh, yes.
Don't really matter.
Might actually have been one of the few 5 points in the game for that. Just the
ability
to have.
Just the ability to go
set.
Stop.
Basically, just add
it
to your dial.
Stop.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? Yeah. He's then going
he's
to for his first action boost.
And you're seven.
Back up and around this way.
Okay.
Just to there. So we can see Fed at least.
Okay.
And we're thinking we're just going to push the limit and take a focus token.
Okay.
Seems like an alright thing to have.
Okay.
Full shields. Huzzah!
Woohoo!
This is how we like it to be.
Top of the stack. This
so,
poor bastard's only got one hull left.
Yes,
right?
He does. That'd be great.
And this guy's still got three?
Yeah, four.
He's gonna... Oh, because of
shield.
The shield. That's right. Alright, so Fett's gonna feed into...
There's some hulls for you.
Gonna feed into Mr. No Numbers there.
No Numbers? Just wants him dead?
Oh, just wants him dead.
Guess what? Roll two dice. There's two hits. Guess what? He's dead.
Yeah, two hits and a crit.
So,
it's
cool.
Enough.
Well, I guess it matters for how much I feed out from the deck. So
yeah.
Let's see. So yeah, full two hits. One hit, two hit. Critical. Loose stabilizer. After you execute a white maneuver, receive a stress token. That is the worst card in the deck to have
on
an
E-wing.
On
an E-wing.
Because it's all white.
Yeah.
So I'm really actually happy that showed up.
Alright, so he
hits. Direct hit, double damage is never a good thing, but...
Your Corrin gets to shoot.
Yes, he does. He's going to shoot both of it, because he might as well, why not? Pretty sure that's going to be range 2, no matter how we shake this down.
Yeah.
Oh. We have three dice.
Put the correct dial.
A blank, a focus, and a crit.
I'm just spending the focus token.
I know, right?
Because Nadru actually isn't all that threatening when he doesn't have an action. He's only got the two dice.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, now I'm going to get three.
My two goes first.
Three for
I'm beyond
range
two.
A five straight.
If I'm beyond
range,
two.
Oh, never mind. Then, yeah, no, we're just keeping the one crit.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. And so Fett's going to roll two evades.
Fine, yeah. That's what I figured. We do get a target lock for trouble.
Yep, you
will
do.
Attempt to
and you can
on.
Double tap this turn if you want.
I could.
No.
In any case, Nadru now, though, is going to do three dice against Corrin.
Yeah, that's what we figured. Three of our own.
No, he's not. Three dice against the B-Wing.
Okay.
Joke. One hit.
B-Wing.
Your moment. Shine.
Shine
like a diamond.
Shine
bright. That was not shining. His last shot.
That was the right shot. I'm sitting here just like
I thought,
like,
I was like,
wait,
yeah.
I was
sitting there going, you're going to shoot Corrin?
This
is the guy who can regenerate a shield. I'm okay
yeah,
with
you
got potentially
it,
getting away.
Yeah, nope.
Exactly.
Like,
so we'll shed.
To deal with this Corrin, then
shed our tokens, right? Oh,
no.
No,
we're not double tapping.
Huh?
We're not going to double tap.
You're not going to double tap?
No.
So that means that target lock drop.
Yeah. That's not going anywhere. Alright, so one less beam guy to play with. I just want to play with my toys, man.
Run away.
Is that so bad?
So bad? So much to ask? Is that so hard?
Yes. Sorry.
Okay, my
no offense,
fives.
Man. But you gotta die.
They all move.
Okay, I'm ready.
I'm almost ready. I know what I'm doing this time, so it's gonna be real quick.
Okay.
It's gonna be quickly finding a new one to die.
We're down to 28 minutes.
Oh yeah, we got lots of life left. Alright, well, make things easy. Beaming is going to advance sensors for Das Barrel Roll.
Das Barrel Roll!
Das Barrel. And Das Barrel is.
The Barrel of the Rollings!
I'm gonna put him just back to the.
It's like Donkey Kong in here with all the rolling barrels.
Oh, yes. And just as many monkeys.
Yeah.
Alright, then we're gonna 2K.
Okay.
Suppress press.
So, you want a hand with that?
I can probably grab it. Actually,
okay,
you can see the front nib's pretty easy here.
That allows. Him to
I'm just getting used to reaching that distance over
this
table.
Yeah.
If it was up where Boba is, I'd probably take you up
on
that offer. Just go to there.
So
I figure that looks all right.
That doesn't work.
Wait, Corrin's stressed, isn't he?
Yes, he was.
I derped.
I'll give you a mulligan. I'll give you a mulligan.
You should have been doing a green maneuver. I completely forgot your distress.
As long as you weren't revealing a red, it's all good.
No, no, no. It wasn't going to be a red, no. It just turns into that, basically.
Okay. Okay.
Really
so, and Drew, it's going to do a forward one.
Well,
I'm pretty sure that's a bump, yeah.
I think it was a bump, no matter what we were doing there, so.
Yeah, it was such a bump.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's cool. He's not getting many actions, this poor
yeah.
Drew guy.
Drew doesn't care. I got my wad off, that's all that matters.
Yeah. Yep. At least he's not
I got mine, I don't care about the rest of you.
He's not shooting the B-Wing. I'm just going to say that much. I'm happy he's not shooting the B-Wing.
And then Fett is going to do a turn two.
Moment
of truth.
He's fine.
Moment of Fett truth.
I know what he's doing next turn as well. Actually, the next turn is the one that's going to be actually really close.
Yeah.
I think he makes it, but it's going to be close for his back.
Yeah, it's going to be super duper
it's
close.
It's this back corner, if everyone can see on the camera, that I'm worried about sticking off just the back end of the table.
You're not the only one.
Yeah.
All right.
Over.
Now
Corrin's going to be moving. Yeah, he's doing a too soft just to clear his stress off.
Cool.
Got full shields already. That's all right. Yeah. All right. So I think Corrin's just going to go to there, and then... Funnily enough, I don't actually fancy
oh
the idea of being
shot. Oh my
shot.
God!
I guess the question is, am I out of your arc already? Here,
yes, you are.
Fancy laser. I'm pretty sure you're absolutely right in that I don't think I even need to barrel roll. I'm
going
to barrel roll out just in case. But
you do not, sir. Fett's going to take some shots.
Yeah, he is. I think
which is great because he hasn't taken any hits this game at all.
Yeah. So I think we're just going to actually take a focus token and not push the limit this turn.
Okay.
Just to keep our options open for the next turn.
Awesome. So Fett has no shot. Go Corrin.
No shot. Corrin. Corrin's up. I believe we're at range 2.
Range 2 on Fett.
And you don't get to reroll this turn.
No, because you're out of range.
Range 1. Finally.
You can actually strip some shields.
That's potential here. There's 3
Whoa,
hits.
Whoa,
we'll
3 hits. Solid.
So we'll take that. Take that to the bank.
Couldn't be much better for him. Blanks.
Oh, 3 shields.
3 shields down.
That's
okay,
a fabulous
two.
Start. That's the start we needed.
Good
here.
Job, Corrin. Good job.
Good job, Corrin. That's a great way.
Okay.
That happens sometime, right?
Drew is going to take his
three
dice on
Corrin. He
has no choice.
Yeah. Hitting a crit. Not bad. All right. We got 3 dice for the focus, should we so desire.
And he'll take the focus. Actually,
one hit. So just shield off Corrin.
So you have to regen next turn.
We have to.
No, you must! I said so!
Them's the rules. You took a shield, Corrin regen. R2-D2 makes it happen. You think you control this ship? No. R2 controls this ship. No, you want, R2's very self-preservation. I think you're actually going to double tap this turn, though, so I'm going to borrow some dice from you.
Sure.
So you have one more.
Yeah, there you go. Sorry, I took them with me.
Alright, so 3 dice, start lock and focus.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll just spend the focus token for 3 more hits.
That's going to get 2 dice, so the best I can make that is 1 hit.
Yeah.
And I'll make it 2 instead. So that's a shield down and 1 hit against the hull. I'm now at half.
That's the start we needed.
There you go, so...
Oh, and sorry, I forgot to shoot the blue squadron before...
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
So, sorry, yeah, he's just shooting his primary.
Range
3
on
it's going to be range 3, yeah.
Five.
There'd be no point.
Even in range?
Nope. Oh, actually, is he not?
Yeah. Not at all.
Not even that far. Oh, interesting. Never mind. Ha!
All right, never mind.
We totally were at the end phase.
Unconsciously, you knew.
There. Yeah. We've got that eye. We can just dead-eye that, right?
That's right.
Yeah, totally.
That's right.
Cough, cough. Anyway, we did double tap, so we're going to throw down that no shooting again.
Oh, boy.
For Mr. Brown there. Guess that's the thing.
Okay, I'm set in maneuvers.
Very good. Now, I guess the question here is, do you go off the table?
That is going to be the trick, isn't it?
The question here. It's a very...
The $64 question right now.
Yep. Oh, yes.
Do I fly Fett off the table?
Probably just...
If it's a hard turn, you shouldn't.
I probably won't. But there's opportunity for me to do so.
Why
am I
getting another drowsy?
This guy
doesn't
want...
I dropped another lure.
Wonderful maneuver a B-Wing can do.
Now that's not a green maneuver, so I can't let somebody have a target lock. So
I think we're
just
gonna do that.
And this guy does a 3.
Actually.
Well, working under the assumption that you make this.
Where would it's I a good assumption, because like if I don't, you're going to get it.
we'll just do that one.
Okay.
Cool. So, one straight, keep the options open, clears off the stress. I'm pretty sure we make this. I think the angle is just oblique enough that
we make it.
Is that in?
Yep.
Cool. Get that guy down there. Slot you back. Slot that back there. Cool. Tell you what. Focus tokens are in season. They're always in. Actually,
they're always in season.
I'm kind of feeling the target lock better, actually.
Okay.
I kind of feel the target lock.
In a combat, boss fires first. Does he have range?
Yeah.
Okay, so... And my five still
focus. It might matter for his survival.
So
I think. I roll that one eyeball and he's got three hits. I'm going to be really sad. I'll just do that. He's starting at the bottom of it all anyway, so if he makes it that far, right?
Okay,
that's fine. Okay. Cool. Yeah, he's just going to take the focus token. Figure it's better for his survival odds.
Good call. And Drew's going to turn two.
I think he's going to be sitting right in front of the B-Wing. Do we want to... Here, let me just mark the B-Wing.
If you don't mind, thanks.
Yeah, no problem. I think that should let you clear it.
How about four blanks?
My finger's in the way, but yeah, there you go. Oh, I think you're just going to make that.
That's not a good start.
Well, that's not very good for him, actually.
No, it's not.
No.
Suddenly, I'm really glad I didn't do the maneuver we're going to do. So.
Wow.
It couldn't be more beautiful if we tried.
That was really shitty.
You take your focus token, because...
And then
that B wing's been hurting all game because of him.
Yeah,
he's like, I'm going to kill you so hard and true.
All right, here we go. Here's where Fett fucks up and flies off the board. Except, I don't think I do.
I think you're good. I think you're good. You just crank that around.
I'm not going to have... Oh, I'm going to have a shot on that B-Wing at least. So I will take my focus. Oh, dude.
And you're actually still stressed. You've only been doing whites.
Oh, you're right. Sorry, I forgot about that.
No, it's all good. But I think you actually don't have
them. Oh, my God. No shots from Fett
again. But
too busy trying to
Corn's got around there. Though, so he's just doing a two bank.
Yeah.
Because we've got to start bringing this whole shindig around sometime.
No, that's okay. That looks like it's just
one.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Hello.
Oh, yeah. You focus that up.
Still can't shoot this turn. So I think I'd rather not get range for one of you. So that brings back the shield token.
Nope. Oh my god, I am rolling horrible.
I'm actually going to take a barrel roll. I'm just going to come over your side just so I can eyeball where I'd like to be a little better.
Yeah.
I'd rather not eat the range one.
Give me one of
these. You are at range two of your own friend now, so that's slightly better, but I give you the free present
range. Yeah, if I'm within range two, I just don't get that
bastard dice. Two of eights on that one. Oh my god.
I'm thinking we actually like this angle out here pretty good. I think that gets us definitely out of range one.
I just want to measure here. See, oh yeah, within range two.
Now, the question is, do we want to push the
focus
token?
I completely
think actually the answer
horrible.
Is, yes, I will.
Yeah?
So
yeah, you sure?
Token, yeah.
It's not going to really help you this turn, though.
I think it will, because you've got a focus token of your own.
I got no shot, and Drew's got a range two shot on you with two dice.
Sure, we'll let it ride. It's just, if I push a limit and I take a stress, then I'm doing a green maneuver next turn. If I take a shot and I take a damage, I'm doing a green maneuver to regen a shield. It's kind of the thought process on
green.
Either way you're doing a green.
It's probably worthwhile then in that case.
Yeah, but the question is basically, do I need to do a hard turn next turn? Because that's what it'll... That's the reason that I want to keep it, my
options.
That's
a tough call.
So it kind of depends on how this all shakes down, especially because Korn's not shooting this turn, is the bigger...
So are you going to hold off on the push the limit then?
Yeah, I'll probably not push, yeah. We'll just let it ride, honestly.
Let it ride this turn?
Okay. We'll see if that's
going
to call in the future.
So, top of the stack, Fett has no shot.
Korn can't shoot.
Nope.
So, Nadru's
got
some shooting on Korn.
Take his two dice at range two.
Yeah. With the focus token, if you so desire to use it.
Well, it's not going to matter because there's one hit.
One hit. All right. Korn, come on, buddy.
Just don't whiffle, Korn. That's a whiffle.
Yes, it is.
So, well, doesn't matter because you're going to regen anyway.
It's, yeah.
So.
It's like, yeah, it's same shindig.
And
so
then you're two.
I've got a range one. I think we're just going to take a four dice shot on you with the focus token.
Yeah,
all right. Did you end up spending that focus token for the
hits?
No,
no,
right. You got a blank and a hit. Yeah. Perfect. Whoop. Whoops.
I tried.
Wow.
Two hits and a crit.
I'm taking something no matter what.
Just see what Andrew rolls with the bank shot.
Oh
no!
Wait,
Wait, here it comes.
What was it? If you can find it.
You see, the trick is you need to add more beer and then your extra improves.
It's a hit.
Oh my god!
It was a hit.
And I managed to pull off two evades.
Two evades, so one
I
trick.
I use his other shield.
His other shield's going back.
Oh my god, he's still alive.
It's on the other half.
It's on the other half?
Yeah.
Okay.
Holy shit!
I almost made that. I just clipped the left.
Oh, I didn't even use that.
Weird
that,
angle
so.
That
sent it. Nah, neither of us used our focus tokens.
No, that's crazy.
That turn, so.
Crazy talk.
Okay.
Okay, so sweep some tokens, set some maneuvers. Holy jeez.
Doing a one bank.
Oh, and Corn can now shoot.
He will do
a... And he's thinking he's going to do that. And obviously his focus will fall.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got a Zed dial.
Oh, there's my Zed dial. That's right.
Yeah. I know, I wish he was dead as well, but he's still sitting there before. He's, isn't
that
far gone
yet? It's not
that
I wish he was dead.
I will...
I do. Although, to be fair, this hasn't been... I've seen Nadru's one-shot interceptors, you know, Karner Jax's, Sundar Fels, Kornhorns, all day, every day. So just
I've
the fact that I've still got a Kornhorn on the table after he got literally exactly what he wanted.
I've seen him leave a K-Wing at a single health.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah. No, it's... I'm pretty... It hasn't not been Nadru's game.
No.
That's the one.
Well, hey, he's
it.
Not dead yet, so...
This is true.
It ain't over.
True. All right, so...
Go blue.
Oh, did I? Actually, before we move on to that, I just want to double check something.
Yeah, no worries. We haven't revealed any yet, so it hasn't even triggered yet.
And,
hasn't started.
Nothing's kicked off the party yet. Why don't we go... Yeah, that's the one. So we're going to do that, because otherwise I think we'd be in a bit of a silly situation.
All right, so bring it on.
Perfect. So we're going to go with advanced sensors, funnily enough. We're going to take a focus token, funnily enough.
Okay.
And we're going to reveal a two soft.
My fives...
Here, I'll move and Drew.
Yeah, I think we clear pretty cleanly. The question was, I was thinking initially of doing a one soft, and I wasn't sure I was going to clear him with the back of the base.
There you go.
But this actually is an okay angle to begin with.
That's a good one right there.
Target lock.
Yeah, perfect. He's got that focus over.
Yeah, I can.
Perfect. Nadru.
Nadru is going to bank one.
Bonk.
Yep. Collision.
How many turns has it been now since he had an action?
Basically since he turned the corner over there.
So, four?
Yeah, thereabouts.
Not interesting.
There we go. And Drew don't care. Fett, it's going to do a forward two.
Okay.
Seems all right.
And he'll take a focus.
Question is, does a B-Wing still have... Yeah, B-Wing still got that shot.
But I don't think I got a shot back at him.
Yeah, the way the angles play out, that rear arc.
Nope. I do drop
you
that.
You drop that, so you do get an action this turn for something.
Okay.
Yeah. Probably won't look like a... focus
evade. That allows
target
me
lock?
To let none of my guys...
Target lock. Yeah. Would you be so kind as to move Corrin for me?
Yeah, let's see what's he
doing.
He's going to do a turn two.
Yep.
I don't think we needed the shield this turn, so he's just going to slot in.
I am
going to
get a shot at Corrin, at least.
Oh, yes, you are. So, Corn, guess what?
Action.
He's going to be pushing limit for a focus on that evade.
Maybe.
Maybe.
No, I'll get to shoot at him. Whether anything actually comes
focus.
Of it, it's another story.
Yeah.
All right, so four dice at Corn.
Yep.
Oh, you missed it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
And I'll reroll.
You reroll the two blanks because you got two guys at range one.
Two guys at range one. Okay, so that one.
Sign.
Okay,
so
I'll turn those up.
Yeah, spend that focus token.
So three hits.
Three hits on Corn, right?
Yep.
Alright, we got three evades coming in hot. Come on!
Or,
hot
hey,
enough!
Hey, there we go, we'll spend that evade token on this one.
Yep.
That's gonna be nothing on the big man.
Oh.
Okay, so Corn, four dice, range one, target lock square.
He's blanking a Drew shot and he doesn't have his evade anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just roll that one back in. This thing.
Woof.
And we'll re-roll this one with the target lock.
Yep.
So the absolute.
And, we'll
and then
focus
the other two up.
For three hits.
The
yeah.
Okay.
I go cross.
And he's got this.
No,
you're not gonna kill me at least.
Just really gonna be able to.
Hey! Only one hit.
Only one hit. Alright, that's alright.
She's not really gonna be able to.
What could you possibly have had to worry about?
Nothing at all.
Nothing at all.
So now, and Drew's gonna
do
how
much left on him now? Four left. Four left on him now.
Yep.
Come on, Andrew.
Three dice from Andrew.
Three on three.
When are you gonna be up?
Ross, that was terrible.
One hit.
You could whiffle.
The defense dice.
Okay.
Not this time around.
It's not defense dice in my hand.
You see, the problem is I'm not flying high intercepters. Then they would be all blanks every time.
Oh, yeah.
Just the way that
I don't fly.
And then you're.
You got the B-wing. He's just going to take four dice. We're going to hit one. With
yeah.
Focus.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, we'll just spend that focus token for three hits.
Three hits then. Okay.
And I just want to leave you on at least two here. Take two. I'll be my guest.
Perfect.
Takes two.
Which leaves me with
fabulous.
Two health.
Leaves down two health. That is that focus token spent now.
Come on.
So, take a while to guess what Korn did.
Yeah. Double tap.
Double tap. Has the target lock. And we'll target lock the two blanks.
Especially if you can get
roll.
Those during the hits, you're done.
Yeah, basically.
You know what? I'll spend the focus.
Oh, one.
Oh,
I got a dodge.
I got a dodge. Two.
Right.
Nope.
Nope.
So I take two.
Boom.
Okay.
And that goes down.
Five.
Oh, boy.
All right.
Yeah,
at least
this,
Drew gets extra dice every single time he shoots.
Oh, yes. He's
the focus.
All my friends are dead. This is amazing.
This
is everything I wanted.
This
is the best day
you
ever.
You only get the one.
Do I have to go back to the hangar?
Four
can I just stay up here?
Fudge, man.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
Move a target lock. And Jonas rerolls.
It's the way they tend to.
It's the way the dice tend to go.
Okay,
man.
So.
I'll
Jonas reroll that. So I get to reroll one or two of my secondary weapon.
One of those.
Okay.
All right.
Attacks.
Cool. Blue squad. Blue squad. He's gonna before he reveals his dice, he's gonna advance sensors for a focus token.
Oh, nice.
And then he's gonna
okay,
do a 2K.
Whoa!
Flips that
dashing, daring, bold, swift.
Two hits, two crits.
Very much.
Well, not swift, but yeah.
Oh, I don't know. Can you
definitely
imagine?
Dashing, daring,
like,
and bold.
Imagine how the cockpit and all the wings have to rotate around, as well as the. It's literally doing basically a big gyroscope movement to turn around like that. It's actually reasonably impressive for a K-wing to be able to, or the B-wing,
yeah.
To be able to do that with the way that they're built in the.
True.
Because in the fluff, of course. This is an entirely, like, this whole ship pivots around
the
cockpit.
No,
so in order for that to
focus,
work,
I don't
it's
care.
Reasonably difficult to do, I'd imagine.
Should be interesting. Okay,
he's definitely stressed out from it, though.
Drew,
how impressive
it's going to forward one.
Oop, bump.
Which I really hope I can complete, but I probably
I think
can't.
You're bumping Korn there.
And same
yeah,
thing,
I totally
four
bump
dice.
Korn.
No focus.
Oh, dear.
Okay, so...
Yeah, you might as well just
Jonas
leave him there
re-roll.
For the moment, because
mm-hmm.
I think you run into the back end of the corner right there.
I gotta
yeah.
re-roll that focus, because Pokemon...
All right.
Cool. So, Korn, at this
nice.
Point,
so,
is going to be doing a 2K
crits.
For the green,
crits,
which
yeah.
goes off his stress and regenerates shield from R2-D2.
Yep.
Can't shoot, but he's definitely moving and hopping. Oh, that is yours, because
yeah.
this is why I keep all these this way.
So,
I
so he's got a
2
base.
I know, but...
Yeah, he's got
but
a 2 base. He's just going to come in along...
Against roll against I can't get worse. It's gonna get better.
Against this, why would we
wreck him? He's just gonna go over there. He's thinking.
It was
and
like
then for his action.
I needed to snuff him out because of his freaking TLTs.
Rather than letting you just have a free shot at Korn,
okay, so
we're just gonna go ahead and
fives.
Boost.
I don't think
just
Jonas has actual. Thank you.
Boost a little further away.
Jonas
actually, no.
Has arc or
a barrel roll.
Nope. So that was my fives.
Thinking we're just gonna barrel roll. I don't know. We are gonna boost it. I think just boosting the one straight means that you won't have the shots. That's just
I'm not
more.
Shooting Korn anyway.
I didn't think you would be, but...
Okay, so I'm
going
to do
so
a
three dice. At your B-Wing.
Give the B-Wing more room to maneuver next turn as well.
Nerd! What the hell?
It's a crit for what it's worth.
Yeah, one crit.
Come on, B-Wing. Once again.
Wow.
The shit, man! What the shit?
B-Wing! That K-turn just wasn't expecting it.
Yeah. Okay, right. And then B-Wing back.
B-Wing back. I think we're just going to take 4 dice, primary.
Yep.
I've been a great game for the tractor, but your list didn't ever really have the... Well, actually, it was a big deal for the Hawk, but after that, it was not really going to be a big deal unless
exactly.
I got the double tap.
Okay.
Foreign on
I'm
the same
focus
Zed.
On anything but blank.
This is looking good so far.
And I need it.
Looking fantastic. So it's in like 4 hits with that focus token
focus
there.
Focus them up? Okay.
Yes, we are. So
and
4 hits.
I get 2.
Okay,
I really I can't roll enough.
And
I don't. And
good game,
that.
Sir.
Good game.
Fantastic match.
Ooh, so what was your one takeaway from this match?
Sweet.
Takeaway probably being E-Wings are still difficult to fly. I mean, I've always, since I got the fighter, I've always enjoyed what they can do, particularly with the sensor options. And actually, advanced sensors on an E-Wing is a really cool thing. With, again, it's a barrel roll ship, only it's got a more maneuverable dial than a B-Wing. The trick is that they have such a limited amount of green. With the push to the limit on Corrin, it can really be difficult because, again, there's this whole bottle of space over here where I just wasn't really lining up very well with the B-Wings to get those tractor beams off.
Yeah.
Purely because I couldn't get the hard turns and clear the stress from the push the limit.
Yeah.
Which would have probably made the tractor beams more effective. That being said, I think the tractor beam on just a Blue Squadron or any B-Wing is fantastic. Fantastic.
The tractor beam's a great ship, highly underrated.
Yeah, because
folks are like, unless you put it on a high pilot skill, it's totally useless. Wrong.
I disagree.
Wrong.
Because the trick of it is it's partially the control aspect. I mean, if you want to see a swarm.
Hey, guys.
Happy birthday, brother.
Thanks, bro.
Oh, yeah. Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. This guy's birthday. Everyone say happy birthday in the comments. All right.
So, yeah, my one takeaway was I have to find a way to keep Palib alive longer.
Yeah.
And I think I'm going to change this list up a little bit. I'm going to get rid of Predator, change that for Wingman. I think I'm going to change the TLT out for the Ion Cannon Turret. Which will then free up enough points
to get the title?
No. To put the cloaking device on it.
I love cloaking device hawks. They
love
work out really, really
hawk.
Well. That's the other list I was considering. Because
Palib doesn't necessarily need to attack. Just his presence on the board completely changes things.
Yeah.
And if I can double his defense dice up to 4 and get him in range 1 to 2 to somebody.
Totally. And the other thing is that leaves your elite pilot skill talent slot open. That's a mouthful.
I'm going to be swapping this for Wingman because I'm going to fly him close to Boba Fett.
Right.
That way when Boba Fett does a stay on target,
okay.
He can shed the stress.
So
and Boba Fett can stay on target more often.
And that's still outlaw tech because of where Wingman triggers, which is at the beginning of the combat phase, you still get the focus token
from the outlaw
tech.
I still get the focus token from
the
outlaw tech.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Cool. No, that's nice.
So
I like that.
I think that'll work out a little better in this since the TLT has sort of like taken a nosedive in the last few weeks.
People gotten used to it. People's lists have something of a plan for it.
Well, and it's not as intimidating. This used to scare the crap out of people, and now they're like, whatever, TLT.
I mean, if you still have 3 of them, it's a big deal. The other thing is the R4 aggro mech being nerfed really meant that the scum TLT really took a nosedive because it was so pivotal to the way that it worked. It's still works.
Good, but you kind of put a recon spec in there
to figure it out.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
So yeah, that was a great game. A really appreciated play.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, to get on for us.
Hi everybody, welcome back. So it was a great match, Matthew. You got a good list there, I think.
Yeah.
Corrin really did a lot of work.
Yeah.
He did his job. That's for sure.
Yeah, no, and the B-Wings, I mean, they definitely help him get there. I'm still up in the air. I mean, this is very much the traditional Corrin Horn build, but I'm still a little bit up in the air about push the limit on him, just again, because we were talking about it a little bit at the end where... just
can't really think of any other pilot skill. Maybe Predator.
Predator. Well, Predator is common. I mean, and it's the same points cost.
And
or
for his
outmaneuver sometimes comes into play because he's often coming around the flank. Exactly. You've got the barrel roll and all that, so that can be cool. And then you're still leaving it free, so if you want those green maneuvers, you get there at 2D2. But honestly, if it ain't broke, probably won't fix it. So,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so I consider taking
like,
a turn.
I like the flexibility that push limit gives you.
Mm-hmm.
To get either your boost, your barrel roll, or your
focus
your
of
boost, or your your focus evade, which pulled off, which was great.
Great.
If you hadn't done your focus evade, then Drew would have hurt you a lot more. Yeah, exactly. So, but because of your focus evade, you managed to basically completely nerf whatever Drew was going to throw at you.
Yeah.
So yeah, very good, very good. I liked it a lot.
No,
my list, I'm definitely going to change it up. I got some ideas for Palib, I think, that will free up a few points there. And I think I might end up picking up another glitter stim to go on Fett.
That'd be good.
And
really
instead
good.
Of the
inertial dampeners, throw glitter stim on them instead.
Glitter stim's really good. And especially because you're already getting all those rerolls from just Fett being having all the things at range 1 to 2 anyway. Having the ability to have that one big turn with glitter stim where you're turning, you get to reroll for those focus results from this and turn over again is a big deal. Boba's my favorite. Easily my favorite fire spray.
Oh, scum best pilot. Fire spray scum pilot. Period.
Actually, probably just the best fire spray pilot. Period. Come to think of it. Cat Scarlet on the Imperial side.
Imperial Cat Scarlet is
right up there. But I think he still takes the cake.
He
just
does.
Because it's
pilot
skill, combined with an amazing and always useful pilot ability.
Yeah, you're almost, if you're close to somebody, you're almost always guaranteed at least one reroll. So it's worth it.
Totally.
All right. Well, hey, thanks a lot for the match. Good times.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next time, guys. Again, like and subscribe. We thrive on your subscribes. And please leave any comments down in the diddly-doo below. Let us know what we did right. Let us know what we did wrong. Changes to the list you'd like to see. Just general ideas you'd like to see us do on the channel.
And wish this guy a happy birthday.
It's my birthday!
It's his birthday. Magic's having a
All right, thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you next time.